Get to enjoy so much, and why the School of Music here at Central Michigan University is a very special place. Without any further ado, let's have a wonderful evening of music. Thank you much.
Thanks for that. At such a beautiful hall. I don't know if you know, but we recorded our first album here about 17 years ago. So it brings us really good memories. The next piece is Strum. You probably heard of it because lately it's been played a lot by Jessie Montgomery, who happens to be our friend. So we are like blown away that she's famous, like a famous composer. She's a very nice violinist. And I remember when she started writing. And so Jessie, you know, is kind of like our generation, and she likes to flip through the music, you know, from one genre to the other. So her taste is very eclectic, and you can hear that in her music. Strum, obviously, you will notice why it's called Strum very soon. So enjoy it. Thank you.
After such a beautiful piece by the lyric. Oh yeah, sorry, thinking about something else. Now we're gonna play for you the Guaguanco. You know, Guaguanco is a very famous Cuban type of dance that, you know, became famous by the African rhythms that Cuba has. And it's very similar to the salsa clave that everybody knows. The trick here that the clave, let's play the salsa clave first, yeah? That everybody knows. That salsa clave is from France. That's the salsa clave that everybody knows.
I don't think everybody knows.
No?
No.
Maybe, yeah. It used to be famous when you go clubbing or go to dance. Yeah. But yeah, that's the salsa clave. But the guaguanco clave is very similar, except the third note of the motif is delayed. So tomato, tomato, I don't know. Nevertheless, it's actually harder to dance, and Ilmar has a very, I don't know, I think theory, we have to say that probably salsa clave or the salsa is actually more famous because it's easier to keep the beat, except the guaguanco is way trickier and way more fun, I have to say. So for you, actually, written by Ilmar's father, Guido López-Gavilán, for us, Cuarteto and Guaguanco. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for joining us here this evening. It's been such an honor to get to play for you all, as well as work with the wonderful students, which we got to experience this morning. So thank you all. It's such a wonderful school, and we only wish that we could get to experience even more of it. So we really wanted to pair these two pieces, and it's especially interesting because we are now going from a composer, Caroline Shaw, who is very well respected, very well regarded, and very popular in her own time. Similar to Jessie Montgomery, she's of our generation, also a string player. She's a fabulous violinist and violist and singer, on top of a fabulous composer. To now go to a composer who is also appreciated in our time, but sadly was not in her own time, and that is Fanny Mendelssohn, the sister of Felix Mendelssohn. And what we know about her life and her musical studies is that, well, she really had no formal musical studies because sadly at that time women were discouraged from being composers. Composition, or really being a performing musician, was still very much a man's game. And if not for her brother encouraging her behind closed doors to compose, we might not have any of the masterpieces that we do, thankfully. So it's thanks to Felix Mendelssohn that his sister continued to compose. And there's actually a funny anecdote behind the premiere of this piece. And that is that actually Felix Mendelssohn, despite being his sister's biggest motivator and supporter, did not like this piece. Something to do with he didn't understand the form or the structure of it. But if you ask me, my own theory is that he was just jealous. But you know, criticisms aside or jealousy aside, it's, again, it's such an incredible piece, and we're so fortunate that it has been rediscovered relatively recently, I believe in the 1970s, which was over 130 years after the composer's death. The manuscript was rediscovered, and it is now getting its due and being performed a lot. So we hope you enjoy the String Quartet by Fanny Mendelssohn.
Thank you. Well, thank you once again for joining us. What a fantastic audience. And as Ilmar said, it's so nice to be back. I personally grew up in Lansing, Michigan. So we flew into the Lansing airport, and it literally felt like I was coming home. And my mom met me. She's here. So she's been... We've had a nice road mom with us, which always helps a string quartet. So for you, we'd like to offer the original jazz tune we got into our repertoire. It's called Take the A-Train, written by Billy Strayhorn, made famous by Duke Ellington. And this tune has taken us all over the world. It's been a lot of fun to be able to diversify our rep and to be able to offer both standard classical traditional repertoire, but also jazz as a genre, our Latin tunes, and lots of music in between. So we feel like this was our beginning, and it's really nice to be with you tonight. So thank you again. We'll be out front to meet and greet you, and we also brought some CDs in case anyone would like to take us home with you. We'd be happy to sign it.
Thank you.